Since Eorzea is growing with so many new Warriors of Light and the Final Fantasy XIV MMO is growing rapidly, I want to share some super important pieces of information that I wish I had when I started Final Fantasy that wasn't readily available. This is a new mini-series to get those super important pieces of information to the Sprouts, Casuals, and returning players. Comment down below if you'd like to see more of this series, and don't forget to Limit Break 3 that subscribe button. Hey guys, my name is Stefan Ash, and today I have a few Final Fantasy tips and tricks for you. As always, you can click my link tree down below to connect with me on social media or consider supporting the channel. I want to give a huge shout out to this week's supporter, Mocha Frapp. Thank you so much, my dude, for the support. Today we're going to talk about 10 important tips of information that I had when I started Final Fantasy XIV that will not only streamline your gameplay, but are just common questions that you're inevitably going to have. This will go in order from starting the game as best as possible so you can apply this to your personal journey. Let's jump into it. Number 1. When choosing a server, try to pick a preferred server if you are able to. You will get double experience all the way up to level 70. This might increase with Endwalker up to level 80. This is the easiest and fastest way to level up for new players. This, however, will not affect your gameplay experience. It merely just gives you some room so you're ahead of the content you're playing. It is not a make or break, however. If there is no preferred server, I still recommend just starting the game, or if you're trying to play on the same server as a friend and it's not preferred, just start anyway. I started as a new character with no bonus, and it was still well above the level cap for most dungeons and content. Number 2, character creation. Unlike many MMOs, the character and the race you start with has no bearing on your stats. You are free to choose any race that suits your aesthetic. You can also change this later with a Fantasia potion if you really don't like how you look. Nothing in character creation will affect your gameplay other than the picking of the class, which will have you start in one of the three areas: Gridania, Uldah, or Limsa Lominsa. Level 1 through 15 will be a different story depending on the city you start in. But then the story merges for everyone around level 15, so you don't really have to worry about missing out. Side note, I actually started two other characters just so I can play through the other two stories to get the full experience. Not needed, but kind of fun to do. Number 3. Generally, healers and tanks wait less for dungeons, trials, and raids. Any content you have to party for usually will be a quicker queue time for tanks and healers. In any MMO, they're always needed, and Final Fantasy XIV is no different. To be contrarian, don't be discouraged to pick a DPS, as you can always ask someone to run something with you, and many people in the main cities won't mind helping out if the queue is taking too long. I rarely ran into this problem myself for my data center, which is Crystal, but some servers and data centers are just busier. Pick the class you would like more. You can always switch later. Your one character can play the entire game with just the switch of a weapon once you unlock the other jobs. Don't get bogged down by your starting class. Just go what feels right, because you can always change it later pretty easily once you unlock the three cities and have access to all the other classes. You will see these quests here, so you want to be a conjurer, botanist, leather worker. Just fill in the blank, but just be aware that when you start over on another job, you start from level 1 for the Realm Reborn jobs. This means you'll have to grind them up to level in order to continue the story, so don't switch too often, just try a few out if you're not happy with your current one. You can change your UI screen. You are not stuck with what's on your screen. There are many tutorials out there on how to change your UI from the very beginning to make it more friendly and less clunky. I have a link above and below on how to do this from the very start of the game. I recommend this, as experiencing the game and being able to see the game is the utmost importance for me personally. What's the point if it's going to be clunky the whole time? 99% of what you see on screen is customizable, and don't feel like you got to stick with the same UI the whole game. Adjusting as you level up and you need access to other things is really the way to go. Main quest or side quest. This MMO is a little special in that the quickest way to level up is to do your main story quest. I repeat, the yellow side quests are not needed here to level up, unlike the majority of MMOs. Focus on the main story quests with one or maybe two jobs. I usually picked a DPS and a healer or a DPS and a tank, as the main story quest gives so much experience, it's pretty easily to level up two jobs at the same time. This also helps you not to get bored of one job all the way through and queue times for later. Don't get sidetracked with the yellow side quest if you want to unlock content. Speaking of unlocking content, your main story quest level is different than your character level. This took me a little while to understand, but you could be a level 40 job level, but your main story quest level is only level 30 or 28, which if you're on a preferred server, might happen anyway. Unlocking content is gated behind the story content, so if you don't have access to something, most of the time you just haven't gotten far enough in the story. Generally, it's always advised to get through the story first. Play at your own pace, but always keep story front of mind. You only have to do it once. Next up is limit break gauge. This is gathered when in parties for dungeons or trials. It is shared for the entire party, and generally the DPS use it right before a boss is going to be beaten to deliver the final blow or near final blow. A lot of new sprouts think this is individual gauges, but the party does share it. Make sure to have limit break on your hotbar or cross hotbar in order to use it for the final boss. Sometimes you will see players use this early on if it's full, since you'll probably fill it up again before you reach the final boss. You will also see a lot of veterans say LB in the chat, which means to use your limit break DPS. Tanks and healers very rarely use the limit break, as the healers, it's for resurrecting or healing everybody, and for tanks, it's for defense, so you always generally want to focus this just for the DPS. Orange telegraphs or orange lines are bad. If you're fighting an enemy, move out of the way of these. Another pro tip is that you only need to move out of the way of the actual orange telegraph and not the actual move. So once the orange goes away, you can move back to that spot. This is especially important for tanking later on, as you want to move as little as possible and keep the enemies planted for your DPS jobs. I can already hear some people saying, well, it's the healer's job to heal. Well, it's the DPS's job not to get punched in the face every few seconds from every single move. Last up, should I do blue quest? Well, that's a yes and a no question. Yes, because blue quests are unlockables that you will need, but sometimes you can get into a spiral and only do blue quests. I'll do blue quests when I get a little tired of doing main story quests to break up the rhythm. Reading the name of the blue quest early on can give good hints as what it is to unlock. They can unlock dungeons, logs, more jobs, all sorts of things. I would say balance your time when you're a little tired of the story and go back and unlock some things again just to break up the rhythm. I have about 50 other tips, but I wanted to keep this video pretty manageable for the new sprouts. If you like this type of video and want to see more of these series, then make sure to comment down below, as I have 100 more things that I could tell you. If you would like to support the channel, then you can do that one of two ways. You can go into the link tree in the description box and support with a direct one-time donation. You will get a shout out in the following video for that. If you want to become a part of the exclusive community, you can go to my Patreon to find exclusive perks for becoming a member, which include access to a private Discord channel for my community, weekly video shout outs, exclusive once-a-month live streams, and much more. If you want to watch more Final Fantasy tutorials, then you can just simply click here.